Здравствуйте.
Whether you have or not begun practicing binary reverse engineering, it can be useful to understand what the portable executable or P format is. But first, let's discuss how any executable, no matter if on Linux or on Windows, is structured. Every file, even if non-executable, begins with something called a magic number. A magic number is basically a set of usually 4 bytes or less, and is used to describe what the format of the file is. For example, if I drag and drop a PNG image inside of a hex editor like I'm hex, if we look at the first 4 bytes inside of the site text view, we can indeed see the letters .png. And if we drop a Windows executable, we can see ZM appear. And those are indeed the magic numbers of these file formats. It's by using this so-called magic number that tools are able to deduce the format of your files. Every executable file is divided with sections, and each section has a specific purpose, and information about them like their location and size is described in a section table. If we open a PE file with a tool like DetectItEasy, which is a very useful tool to analyze any binary file, and then head into Entropy, we can view the different sections they are. The main one you will always see is the .text. This section contains all the instructions of the program and is where all the execution happens. Another section you will always see is the .data section. This section, as its name implies, contains all the global and static variables of your program. You might hear about the .bss section, which has the same purpose as the .data section, but it's strictly for uninitialized variables, though it is part of the .data section. You can imagine it as if the .data section was divided in two, the left part being the initialized data and the right one being the .bss or uninitialized data. There usually also is an R data section, which is a section just like the data section, but strictly for read-only data, so you cannot write to it. Now diving into PE specific tables, you will find the IData section, which is a section just like the R data in the sense that it is read-only, but in its case it is used to store something called the import table. The import table is basically a table containing information about all the functions stored in dynamic libraries, aka DLLs. So they are used to allow programs to know where to go to call certain functions from libraries. Following the same theme, you can find the eData section, which is just like the IData but for the export table. And if you find one, it should be because you're analyzing a DLL file. And the export table is the same thing as the import table but for the exported functions. Now there are many other sections, but they're not really important to talk about here. Now getting into the actual PE specific stuff, there are a couple of headers and for the sake of efficiency, I will only describe the useful fields of each one of them. The first header in this format is the DOS header. It is 64 bytes long and exists because of MS-DOS, which was an old branch of operating systems developed by Microsoft. The goal of this header is just to allow old systems like MS-DOS to be able to parse the executable just to execute the DOS stub, which is right after this DOS header, which usually just prints the message, this program cannot be run in DOS mode, so it is pretty much orally useless. Then there is the COF or Common Object File Format header, which is a format for executables introduced for Unix systems. And the COF section stores a variety of informations like the type of machine, aka architecture, a timestamp, and even informations about the sections, though it is not a section table. After that there is the optional header, which is massive and can be divided in a couple of subsections. The first section of this optional header is the standard COF fields, in which you can find many useful fields like a magic number specifying the type of PE, because there's also a variety of flavors of PEs, but we won't be getting into that. There's also a size of code, which stores the size of all sections together. There's also the relative virtual address or RVA of the entry point of the program. And if you don't know, an RVA is basically an offset from the start of the file inside of the memory to a location. There's also the base code field, which holds the RVA of the start of the .text section. And there's also another field which specifies the RVA to the start of the data section. Next up, there is the window specific field section. In this part, you find informations like the size of image, which is the size of the whole file, and also a checksum of the file. After that, there is the data directories section. It contains fields about a couple of tables and their size, like the import and the export table. And finally, there's the section table section, which holds a list of entries, each describing the following informations about the sections of the PE: its size, its RVA, and even flags describing if it can be written to, read, or even executed. I would like to thank El Sorvise de la Mula and Mr. Cookie for supporting me on my Patreon and all the others. You can join my Patreon too to get exclusive access to private code and videos. So it's already the end of this video, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.